Okay, and guys, this is the JF100RS Crystal CPU cooler from JIUSHARK. This is the full review. Now, I've got some audio test audio to show you how loud it gets from 50% to 100. And we've got thermals. Now, I have done four benchmarks, like my normal ones. I do Cinebench R23, I do Blender Classroom, Blender BMW, and 3D Mark CPU test. Now, remember, these tests are purely for maxing out the CPU to generate as much heat. Now, the CPU did hit 140 watts, so at least you get an indicator. So, let's get into the benchmarks, then we'll have a chat. Okay, so you've seen the benchmarks. Yes, this little cooler did handle the 5900X very good. And yes, it's a very small air cooler. I have got ones that are the same size from Thermal right now. I would love to do a comparison. If you guys want to see that, please make sure you let me know down below. If not, then please let me know what you want to see, because after these three CPU reviews, I will be doing overclocking testing. I will be setting the 5900X to 175 watts, and that's going to push a lot of voltage and a lot of current into it, as well as amps. And what I'm going to do is do all tests individually, but what I will do first is I will do head-to-heads with this, with Thermalright's equivalent, because there is a 90mm air cooler that they do that's similar to this in design, except for RGB. So, what are my initial thoughts of this little air cooler? First of all, it's a very nice air cooler. I do love the design. The overall design on top does look something like the AK400 from Deep Cool, as it's got a aluminium type shroud on top. And yes, the base plate isn't exactly, it hasn't got an attachment. What it is just the heat pipes sliced down in a mill. So, overall, it's a nice little air cooler. I love the overall design. It's small, it's tiny, doesn't draw a lot of power. But what I want you guys to know is that this is a 220 watt TDP CPU cooler. So, basically, it should be able to hold the 5900X are 175 watts, but we don't know. But this is their latest one, so it is for AM4, it's AM5, as well as LGA 1700. CPU coolers over 220 watts, I think, will struggle a little, but we will do testing. I will make sure that when I do that type of testing head-to-head, and I do put the 5900X as a higher wattage, it will draw a lot more power and it will pump a lot more heat. So then we will initially see what this little thing is capable of. But my scenarios with my review may enable PBO, because not a lot of people will adjust things in the BIOS because they don't want to break something. And yes, you can do that by doing any certain adjustments that you're not comfortable with doing or not used to, you can damage something. So that's where the head-to-head videos I do will come in handy, because I will push this to its absolute limit and I will make sure to know that this little thing by here can hold up the wattage. But overall, it's a very good little air cooler. I do really love the little design, and I will make sure to put up a little bit of a slide by here so you guys can see what it looks like. But if you want to see what it looks like in a finished build, please go watch the unboxing. I do put a B-roll in that video, and what I will say is this little air cooler is stunning when it's lit up, because the top lights up by its as well. Now, my negatives with this are the cables. Is that now, I would have loved a different way of doing the cables. Now, yes, they do connect them together, which is very good. That is a good thing. I will say that is a good thing, and it hasn't got masses of cables, but they could have done it a bit more cleaner. But overall, there's a lot of different brands out there that don't do it this way, with the like that, where it's split. They just do a normal ARGB connector from the fan. But because this has got RGB at the top, it is synced together. So that's a good thing. Overall, I love the fact that it's 4-pin PWM. All manufacturers, any CPU brand, CPU cooler brand, should go all 4-pin. I'm sorry, but 4-pin is better because it gives the consumer the right to adjust things. 3-pin, you can't really adjust it. So, yeah. Overall, it's a good little air cooler, and believe it or not, it's not very expensive. This is around the £20 mark, I think. Not 100% sure, but I will make sure to put it in the video so then you guys know. And what I'd like to say to JIUSHARK is a big thank you for sending it out. I have got the other two, the testing is done. I've just got to make the videos. But after this, it will be coming the AOC League of Legends monitor review, because that has to be done, because I've got more monitors coming. I've got another one from AOC, and I've already received one from BenQ. So, what I'd like to say is a big thank you for guys who tuned in to watch, and I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to subscribe, and as always, this is Rich from WelshyTech. Goodbye.